I understand.
Cervical cancer is an uncommon type of cancer that affects the woman's cervix. The cervix is the entrance of the womb from the vagina. Cervical cancer often has no symptoms in its early stages. If you have symptoms, they would probably be unusual vaginal bleeding, which can occur after sex or in between periods or maybe after the menopause. Abnormal bleeding does not mean that you definitely have cervical cancer though, but it should be investigated by your GP as soon as possible. If your GP suspects that you might be having cervical cancer, you should be referred to a specialist. Screening for cervical cancer is very important. Over the course of many years, the cell lining of the cervix will undergo a series of changes. In rare cases, the precancerous cells can become cancerous ones. However, cell changes in the cervix can be detected at early stages and treated, so the risk of cervical cancer will be minimized. During screening, a small sample of cells is taken from the cervix and checked under the microscope. The test is called the cervical smear or the pap smear, and it's done at your GP or a specialist. An abnormal smear test result does not mean that you definitely have cancer. Most abnormal results are caused by an infection or the presence of treatable precancerous cells rather than cancer itself. It is recommended that women who are between the ages of 25 to 50 are screened every 3 years, and women older than 50 are screened every 5 years. Almost all cases of cervical cancer are caused by the human papilloma virus, HPV. HPV is a very common virus that is often spread during sex. There are more than 100 different types of HPV, many of which are harmless. However, some types of HPV can disrupt the normal function of the cells of the cervix, and this can eventually trigger the onset of cancer. HPV is called human papilloma virus, and it has two main important dangerous types, which is HPV 16 and HPV 18. They are responsible for about 70% of all cases of cervical cancer. These types of HPV infections have no symptoms. Many women will not realize that they have the infection. However, it is very important to be aware that the infections are relatively common, and most women who have them don't develop cervical cancer. Using condoms during sex offers some protection against HPV, but it cannot always prevent the infection. If cervical cancer is diagnosed at an early stage, it is usually possible to treat it using surgery. In some cases, it's possible to leave the uterus in place, but in many women, it might need to be removed. The surgical procedure used to remove the whole uterus is called hysterectomy. Radiotherapy is also an alternative to surgery for some women with early stages of cervical cancer. In some cases, it's used alongside the surgery. More advanced cases of cervical cancer are usually treated using a combination of chemotherapy and radiotherapy. Some of the treatments used can have significant and long-lasting side effects on your health, including early menopause or infertility. Many women with cervical cancer will have complications, and these complications can arise either from the disease itself or as a direct result from the treatment. The treatment includes radiotherapy, surgery, and chemotherapy. So the complications associated with cervical cancer can range from relatively minor, such as minor bleeding from the vagina or having to urinate more frequently, to life-threatening ones, such as severe bleeding or kidney failure. Remember that early detection and treatment of HPV infection can save your life. So if you're sexually active with multiple partners, or if your partner has or had been active with multiple partners, it is wise to have regular checkups at your gynecologist. I wish you the best of health.
This video contains general information about medical conditions. The content might not be suitable for everyone and should not be treated as such. always consult your doctor before using medications. The medical information is provided without any warranties or legal obligations to those who might apply them.